rotate crews, so it's not the same people out there every day. And plus, areas that aren't experiencing fire are sending crews. So we've had crews, for example, from the Hunter and Sydney, sending crews down south to help out with fires there. If these fires up north, obviously, are going to continue for some time. We'll send up relief crews up there as well.
Great. Deputy Commissioner, thank you very much for your time. So, Matt, we're not quite out of the woods yet, but hopefully there is some relief in sight.
Let's hope so. Thanks very much for the update, Amanda. To some breaking news now out of Melbourne, and there are reports a number of people have been injured after a four-wheel drive competing in a mud race ploughed into the crowd. We'll bring you more details as they come to hand. Well, residents in northern Tasmania say they were alarmed after a 3.4 magnitude earthquake rattled their towns this morning. The quake hit 10 kilometres offshore from Wynyard in the state's north, sending tremors through Burnie and Launceston. There are no reports of any damage. Communities in WA's northwest have escaped the brunt of tropical cyclone Narelle. She weakened to a Category 3 overnight and travelled away from land. But there are fresh concerns about another low developing off the coast. Jessica Brown filed this report from Exmouth.
The wind is continuing to howl here in Exmouth, and it's been relentless through the night and today, and although it's fairly strong, they haven't been destructive, and this is about as bad as it's supposed to get for Exmouth. Overnight, a massive surf lashed the coast, and a higher-than-normal tide swallowed the marina.
If it was direct or any worse than this, I think there'd be a lot of problems with flooding.
Daylight brought the clean-up with sand and debris covering the road.